Good morning. Welcome to Children's Church. Enjoyed that song, boys and girls. Now that we've got our voices warmed up, let's bow our heads and say the Lord's Prayer together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Are you ready for a Bible story? Well, I have one for you today, just like every Sunday. But today I want to talk about measuring the love of God. Do you think you can do that? Well, one of my favorite Bible verses begins, "For God so loved the world." I was thinking about that verse and wondering just how great God's love is, how big it is, and how in the world could we ever measure it? This morning, I've got some things that we often use to measure stuff. I have a measuring cup. And I have a clock, and I have a yardstick, and I have a strange-looking calendar, but it's a calendar nonetheless. This says, this is us, blended and blessed, because it's a calendar. And if you look across there, there's all 12 months of the calendar. And for every circle that hangs down from there, that's somebody's birthday. If there's a heart, it's their wedding anniversary. So let's talk about what we need to measure things with. If I were going to measure ingredients, if I were making some cookies, which one of these would I use? That's right. I'd put all the right amount of ingredients in this and probably several other measuring cups and mix it all together and hopefully make a really tasty batch of cookies. Now, if I wanted to know how long to leave the cookies in the oven, what would I use to measure the time? I'd have to use the clock. A yardstick wouldn't tell me how many minutes, would it? The calendar, I wouldn't want to leave it in there for days or months. And the measuring cup, well, you can't put time in a glass cup, can you? So we'd have to use the clock to measure the time. If I were building something, what would I use? That's right, I'd use the yardstick, wouldn't I? If I were going to see how fast I could run around the block, that's right, I'd use a clock. So we have to use different things to measure, don't we? Could we use a measuring cup to measure God's love? No. Could we use a ruler to measure God's love? No. Because do you think God's love is longer than this yardstick? I think so. I think God loves me to the moon and back, so we don't have anything that would actually measure the love of God, do we? No, we don't. But you know, I didn't tell you all of my favorite verse. The rest of my favorite verse, after God so loved the world, is that He gave His only Son, that whosoever believes in Him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Wow. That is in the Gospel of John, chapter 3, verse 16. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So, how much does God love you? He loved you enough to send His Son Jesus down from heaven to be in the world and to give His life for our sins. That's a lot of love, boys and girls. Today that these boys and girls understand how wide, how long, how high, and how deep Your love really is. Thank You, God, for Your love, a love so great that You gave Your one and only Son so that we could have eternal life. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, boys and girls, until next Sunday, bye-bye.